Hi, I'm Dr. Naftali Serrano, and this is a Behavioral Health Consultation Podcast. Today's podcast really is born of a brief conversation I had with a gentleman, I believe it's from Sanford Health, John Ulvin, who noted that it might be helpful for users of electronic health records to have a way to compare and contrast what they do across health records, and also particularly for users of Epic, which is the major EHR here in the United States, to know how we use the electronic record as part of our work in integrated care. So that's what our podcast is going to be today. So it'll be a little bit more boring, I think, than most of the podcasts. Not that these are terribly scintillating, but nonetheless, the rest of this podcast is going to really be a screencast of the way in which we at Access Community Health Centers use Epic. So you see at least most of the functionality that we put to use for our work on a day-to-day basis. So hopefully that's helpful. Another idea out of the Collaborative Family Healthcare Association conference where I met Dr. Ulvin. Another idea that came out of another conversation that will be in a future podcast that you can look for is just a little bit more on soap note writing and some of the methods we use to employ to train our folks and how we do that. So that'll be coming up in a future podcast whenever I have a few seconds to get one of these out. So hope if you enjoy the podcast. If you have any questions, please let me know. But for now, here's Epic in its use in our use case for behavioral health. Hope you enjoy.
And I'm not able to show you a screen with a bunch of patients on them because for privacy issues, obviously, but I have here basically what the screen would look like, and you'd see rows of patients who are scheduled here. And here I have selected the folder that just shows us patients related to the behavioral health team. And so you'd see typically at the beginning of a day, six patients scheduled here at 9, 9:30, and 10:30, 1, 1:30, and 2:30. And those would be the patients who scheduled appointments beforehand to see behavioral health, usually patients that we've seen on warm handoff at other visits. And so you'd have that, and then you'd also be able to click on other provider schedules here to see their patients as well for the day as you scrub the schedule at the beginning of each half day to get a sense of who might be seeing behavioral health. Now, one of the things that you'll do during the day is you'll be adding patients to that list of patients as you see warm handoffs. So we're going to show you here how to do that. You go here to Epic and then appointments. We're going to choose a fake patient here from one of several fake patients. Let's pick this 51-year-old here. And it opens up something called the appointment desk. Now, most providers in the clinic, and most staff in the clinic, in fact, don't have access to this this view. So they wouldn't even have access to that button. So that's one of the things we had to ask for permission to have at the beginning. And we had to do a little bit of education around that because they're not used to having providers in clinic be able to schedule appointments. Usually it's only registrars or call center personnel. But in our case, because we're seeing warm handoffs same day, we have to be able to add those patients in for those visits. All the other appointments are made by registrars and call center, those follow-up appointments. So we click the Make Appointment button here, and a visit type for us is an OFF visit. Provider type would be BHCE for BHC East. This is our group scheduling. Again, we don't schedule for individuals. We schedule for the BHC team, and this is important because it communicates to the patient that they may be seen by one or multiple behavioral health consultants each time they come in, and they are alerted to that as they first meet behavioral health. Though we do maintain some consistency by having consistency of schedule, so some of the same folks are there on the same day at the clinics. We're going to pick the, in this case, a future date just because it's just easier for our example here. But usually you'd be scheduling and choosing the same day of. All right, you hit the search button. Then you see here the slots that are available. See those green slots, 9, 9:30, 10:30, 1, 1:30, 2:30. Now, when you're scheduling in a warm handoff, it doesn't really matter where you put them in the schedule. All we do for statistical purposes is we try to put them somewhere near the time that they were actually seen so that we know how many patients were seen in the morning versus the afternoon. In this case, I'm just going to squeeze them in here. And there's a whole bunch of pop-up screens that you'll have in most scheduling systems that serve specific functions for call center personnel and for registrars, some of them having to do with insurance and other things. More often than not, they're not terribly helpful for behavioral health purposes, except when you have, for example, patients with insurances that have prior authorizations that are necessary, and some of those pop-up screens might relate to those prior authorizations. But otherwise, you're just going to be hitting a lot of continue and continue buttons to get through all the screens. So you see here at the bottom, it says the visits for the 21st with BHCs at 9:15 for 15 minutes. And again, the length for BHC purposes really doesn't matter. We're going to use what time we need to see the patient. We hit schedule, and then again, another insurance screen that really doesn't mean a whole lot. Another insurance screen that doesn't mean a whole lot. And then we keep hitting accept. Again, a demographic screen that's obviously all fake. And this is actually a new feature here that is related to the Ebola situation, and that has to be put in there. And there you go. Now back in the appointment desk, you see that the schedule is there. And again, if this was, this would have been like doing a warm handoff for the 21st. Same procedure for scheduling appointment. You're just doing it on the same day of. All right, so now we have the appointment there. If we go back here to the screen, we see that the appointment is listed here on the on that page related to that date. So that's basically how we schedule an appointment. Without talking it through, it takes really about 20 to 30 seconds to make it way through. Then let's take a look at what it looks like to do a chart review. So let's open up the chart here. And what you'll see here in Epic is that the left side gives you a bunch of tabs. It gives you access to different sorts of information. And the first tab, which is the most important, usually is the chart review tab. And then there's two tabs here across the top that we use significantly. And one is the encounter tab, so it's a list of all possible encounters. And then the other one is just a different kind of view, which is basically a notes tab. So this loads all the specific notes. So, an encounter may have different notes associated with it, depending upon where the patient was seen and what happened. I usually stick with the encounters tab, and when I'm doing a chart review before I go in and see a patient, I'll read maybe the first couple of encounters, meaning the most recent encounters. And if there are any BHC notes listed, I will usually look through those as well. Now, in this case, there's no BHC notes listed for this patient. This patient is actually not even a patient. That's not a real patient, obviously. But if they did, they would. Let's just take a look at here. Again, none of these notes are really terribly filled in because it's a fake patient, but this is where you'd read the note here on this side of the screen. And you'd see different sections in the note there. Now, the other thing, other than reading the last couple of notes here that you do, is you look at the problem list. Problem list is basically a list of diagnoses, but it's not a list of all the diagnoses that have been applied to this patient over time. It's just a list of diagnoses that have been added specifically to the problem list. So you see here in behavioral and psychiatric that a couple have been added here, ADHD, anxiety, and depression, but there's really across the board. And let's say I wanted to add something here. I could add, for example, some note related to how the patient was, let's say that they went to the emergency department on a certain date, and I wanted to note that here. I might write that note related to suicidality here, and I can save that. And I just hit the accept button, and that note then is related there for future purposes. And that can be a really helpful thing for any sort of notes that you want that are not necessarily tied to a specific encounter or note, but that you just want associated with the diagnosis, or something to be known about the patient related to that diagnosis. The other tab that you want to look at before when doing a chart review is the medications tab. And so if we look here at medications, we see that this patient is on a slew of medications, which is very typical of the modern patient. And there's ways to filter it. So if you wanted to, for example, look at the different medications, you can filter it by therapeutic class, for example. This patient is not on any psychiatric meds, I can see here pretty quickly. But if they did, there'd be tabs for those medications as well. So another good way to do that. And then you can look at the history tab just to see what are the medication or prescriptions this patient has had that have been provided over time. So problem list, your med list, your chart review. Now, one other kind of item here to look at when you're looking at in Epic, looking through notes, is that you'll be looking, at least in this encounters view, at a lot of different encounters. Some of these might be, for example, telephone encounters, and because this is a dummy patient, they actually don't have any telephone encounters listed, but most patients have a lot of telephone encounters or other sort of miscellaneous type encounters that you'll see here. Some of those might be important, but some not. So you can create filters up here that remove some of those encounters. So in this case, I'm hiding any additional visits, and I'm really looking at office visits here just by with this filter. And this filter is turned on for me all the time, which really helps with being able to see it. But if I uncheck it, you see here a bunch of telephone encounters here. So again, not much is filled in because it's a dummy patient. But you'll see here, here's a letter that was written. So it gives you different views of the information. And most EHRs will have some functionality like this. All right, so one last thing that we look at for a chart review, which is here, is flow sheets. Let me show you here ambulatory vitals, because that's likely to have some information in there, hopefully. Yep, and it does. So a flow sheet is basically a way to look at some of the information in the EHR that you can look at across time in a table format. So, for example, you have here systolic blood pressure, and you can even graph it, although I don't really find it terribly helpful, as you can see there. But either way, flow sheets is a way to do that. Now, I'm going to close out of flow sheets here and go back in. There are some that we use for BHC purposes. For example, there's this mood check-in screen that we have used in the past. There's ASQs that are entered here in MCHATs. There's this psychiatric adult rating scales. I'm going to open that one up because that's the one we use the most. And unfortunately, that doesn't have anything in there for this patient. But if it did, it'd have basically a date selected, and then it'd have things like PHQ-9 scores and the like. In fact, in a moment here, when we chart on this patient, we'll add a score so you can see what that looks like. But just so you know, that flow sheets is one way that Epic has to look at those kind of data. So let's go into kind of charting for the patient. Right now we've just been reviewing the chart. And a good chart review, remember, for us is something that really takes about, you know, anywhere between 60 to 120 seconds, I would say, to do a good chart review and be ready to go in to see a patient. But let's double click on this patient, which you'll... And of course this is a future encounter, so it's giving me a little bit of warning sign. It's not understanding why I'm doing this. So I'll just take you through what I do. So it opens up, when you open it up in encounter mode versus chart review, it opens up to a note, adds another tab here called the visit navigator. And we're going to start off with just applying a chief complaint. So in this case, let's just do a depression. And that's just basic, that's not a diagnosis, it's just what did the patient come in for, and they're canned. The next tab that I'm going to go to is my diagnosis and orders, and here is where I'm going to assign a diagnosis. Now here are all the problems that were on the problem list, and if there was one that applied, I might move it over. So for example, this 300.4 ICD-9 code for anxiety and depression, that fits what I'm going to work with here for charting, so I'm going to put it there. And then here I'm going to put a level of service. Our most typical level of service is 90832, and it fills that level of service code in. So that's obviously for billing purposes. And basically what it's going to do is connect this diagnosis with that billing code behind the scenes. Once we're done there, we go back to our visit navigator. And then we're going to, our next stop here is progress notes. And you'll notice that you can tab through here or use these to get to it. Either way, it's the same thing. So we're going to create the note here, and then we drop in our template by just applying a smart phrase. That smart phrase is .2a. That's our template. And there it gives us our template where we can just start applying our note. And if I hit F2, it takes me through the note to the sections that I have to fill in. So that area that's been darkened here on this part of the screen here is the area that I'm going to start working in right now. I'm going to make this a little bit, see if I can make this a little bit bigger here to make it easier. And I don't know how easy this is for you to see, but I'll make it as easy as possible, hopefully. So I'll hear patient with depression. Oops. Got to click on there again. All right. Patient with depression related to marital discord and job loss. With poor social support, who would benefit from, thought restructuring and problem solving skill development. All right, so that's just a quick and dirty basic assessment. If we tab through, these are things that we created, or some of them we created, some of them are already existing as kind of smart sets in the, or smart phrases in the in Epic functionality. So this is stages of change, so we fill in. Let's say this guy's at the action stage of change. Actually, this is a lady. I should modify that. And then intervention type. This actually ends up being more of a Medicare thing. This is a Medicare requirement to have an intervention type, so let's do CBT for this. And then again, we're going to see this person back, let's say, in 2 weeks. Here, this is a left as I'm changed, but if I want to change it here, let's say PCP started fluoxetine 20 milligrams. We tab over patient to let's say journal negative thoughts using provided chart. I hit again. Let's see, patient to address. Patient to apply for new jobs this week. All right, so again, just examples of stuff. All right, and then again, we tab or hit F2 over. Patient here, say this is the first time with SWARM regarding depression. And we type in a list of symptoms. And then I'm not going to type in a bunch of stuff here, but I might type in, you know, a bunch of stuff here related to the marital stress, some of the job situation, any other subjective issues that the patient, you know, talked about in about 2 or 3 sentences. The duration of a problem, let's say it's 6 to 12 months. It's moderate in degree. There's no current suicidal ideation. You notice it skipped through some things, so I'll look back to make sure that that it's all correct here. So yeah, he's oriented times 3, and mood, let's say, was stable, appearance was fine, no harm to self. Let's say some current alcohol use but not abuse. So you have lots of options there. No med changes there. And then we come down here, no intern saw this patient with me. And let's say I spent 20 minutes with this person. So there we have basically a standard template that obviously would be more here in the subjective template, but it gives you a sense of what that would look like. There, let's hit accept here for a second. And so that would be done. Now let's say we had some questionnaires that we entered in. Just like we talked before, we'd go here to Doc Flow Sheets. And I've set it up so that these scales open up automatically. Otherwise, you'd have to go searching for the scales. But let's say he had a PHQ-9 score, and his PHQ-9 was 15, and his impairment level was a 2. We'd put in there his GAD was a 12. And again, his impairment was a 2. You get a sense of how Epic then does this, and we'd hit File here, which would basically save that result there for you. We also have, Epic also has a, if you go back to the Visit Navigator, now you can also manually add in these things here. So let's just edit this here for a second. Just so you how you can add in some things. So if you just type another smart phrase here, like this this smart phrase, for example, we have something called an ACE score here. It drops in this smart phrase within whatever text you're writing and then gives you stuff to fill in. So let's just type in a fake one there. Gives you something. Now for the score, the PHQ-9 score, in chart review, it would show that PHQ-9 score as part of the set of aspects of that encounter that were present. Epic also has this other questionnaires function that's there as well. And again, we use only a small part of this actually, but it does have these aspects that you can use as well. I'm just showing you that so you can see the different places to put in things. All right, so you have a lot of this stuff here that's available. Once the next step you'd have after progress notes is follow-up, and here we're going to say it's 2 weeks from that date. You could add the PCP there, which we often do since we are consulting to the physician, so we'll put the PCP there. Hit there, and then we just basically close the encounter. And that would be it. That encounter would be closed and done. Now I'm going to show you one other important aspect of the medical record, and that's in-basket management. And I can't really show you the real in-basket here because it has a lot of confidential information. But basically, it's just a place for communication to happen. So I'll show you how a new message occurs here. So it looks very much like an email, and you can send it to other members of your team. So in this case, I'll send it this message to Dr. Zyla Schreider, and it might be call patient with info as a subject. I'll hit that equal sign, which brings up that last patient, but you can type in any patient's name there. And then here you write in the note. And what's really cool is you can actually decide when you want the message to be sent. And this is helpful, for example, for situations where you might want to send yourself a message to call a patient. And so you'll put in a future date, say in a week, and then have it to call that patient there. In this case, you won't really send that message. But this is a place for that to happen. This is also a place for things like chart co-signing. So if one of my trainees was seeing a patient and wrote the note and needs me to co-sign that note, it would appear here in a folder called chart co-sign. And I would just click there and be able to co-sign the note from that note, from that folder. So I hope this gives you an idea of some of the ways in which we use Epic and some of the ways that this might compare or contrast with the EHR.
All right. Well, there you have it. There's how we use Epic at Access Community Health Centers. If you have some ideas about how you use Epic, ways in which the Epic implementation at your site is slightly different, or ways in which your particularly EHR has some functionalities that look similar or different, hey, post them here. Send questions, queries, comments, all that can be helpful for folks to share information across all that we do. Once again, I'm Dr. Niftal Serrano. Thanks for listening. Catch the next podcast, hopefully coming up in about a month or so.